The NMOS transistor operates as a switch, much like this household light switch. The terminals of the switch are like the source and drain of the transistor. The control lever is like the gate. When I apply a high voltage to the gate, which is like pushing the lever up, the source and drain terminals are connected. When I apply a low voltage by pushing the lever down, the source and drain terminals are disconnected. The control lever is insulated from the source and drain terminals. If I turn the switch upside down, I get the model of the PMOS transistor. When I apply a low voltage to the gate, the source and drain are connected. When I apply a high voltage, the source and drain are disconnected, exactly the opposite of the NMOS transistor. Here is a model of a CMOS inverter. A high voltage is connected to the source of the PMOS transistor, and ground is connected to the source of the NMOS transistor. Right now, both transistors are off, so the transistor drains are floating or not connected to anything. When I apply a high voltage to the NMOS gate, the NMOS source and drain are connected, and the NMOS drain is pulled down to ground, as indicated by the blue light. When I apply a low voltage to the PMOS gate, the PMOS source and drain are connected, and the positive battery voltage reaches the PMOS drain, as indicated by the white light. There are some extra wires in back to make the LEDs light up, but they are not part of the CMOS model. I need to avoid turning on both switches at the same time because it would short-circuit the power supply and ground. This would quickly drain the battery and generate a lot of heat from the high current. Furthermore, in a real CMOS circuit, I need to avoid the situation here with both transistors off and the output floating. To prevent both of these undesirable conditions, I'll connect the two gates together so that they always have the same voltage. Now, when I apply a low voltage or logic 0 to the input, the output is high or logic 1. Conversely, when I apply a high voltage or logic 1, the output is low or logic 0. This is the inverter function. When one transistor is on, the other is off, so there's never a short circuit from power to ground, and the output never floats. In the next video, I demonstrate a logical NOR function and the logical OR function using light switch models.